Instagram, DMs.
Put this on, Jake Gibb. I'm like, I don't even know who these people are. I might phone people up going, who's Gibb? Who's Face Sensei? I don't know who they are. You know, but that's the world we live in. These guys, they're celebrities. They've got following. And at the end of the day, if they're taking it seriously enough, some of them have had fights already, you know. It's just madness. I don't know what to think.
Are we likely to see more and more YouTube personalities on proper boxing shows to broaden the appeal of boxing, which essentially is quite a small market?
Possibly, but it's got to be decent. I don't want people on there that can't fight. I'm sorry. I watched one of the fights on the undercard of the last show. Some bloke was doing the floss and the other one was doing that thing my kid does. Was it the hike or something? Not for me. Not for me. Jake Paul and KSI can fight. They're in great shape. They're athletes. They take it seriously. I'm good with that. They've turned professional. They had their medicals. They're doing VADA testing. They're doing everything that pro fighters should do. And they're training like pros. So I respect them. Let them fight and let them entertain.
From your podcast, Rio Ferdinand and Wayne Rooney.
Yeah, I spoke to you about. I was with Wayne Rooney at the Golovkin fight. He wants to fight Jonathan Ross.
Okay.
But he wants to fight. He wants to fight Rio Ferdinand as well. Who knows? I mean, look, like people love boxing. Wayne Rooney's been boxing all his life. He can fight. Rio Ferdinand had a little stint. People love the thought of the challenge of having a fight. I've been in BBC Sport Relief got in touch with me, and they want me to run a series for Sport Relief. Same kind of thing. I think it's great. Anything that gets people interested in boxing, whether it's participating, whether it's watching, whether it's going to our shows, whatever it is, it's got to be great for the sport. Last couple, guys. We've got to go.
Maybe how crazy is that? You've been to the Fury Klitschko.
Oh, mate. No, that was enough. I mean, on another level. You know, the thing is, anyone that came tonight from our world just leaves going, that's the craziest thing I've ever seen. I mean, from that world, they're like, yeah, it's like that. Yeah, this is what the last one was like, you know. But I'm just like, and again, it's the ferocity of the fans. It's not like, ha, ha, ha. It's like, I mean, there were things, someone threw a tab of Vaseline at me. You know what I mean? Well, I'm not sure what he was insinuating.
Maybe you pick up the condoms.
Chisora. Maybe it was Derek Chisora. But there was a few bits up on the stage, a few coins as well, which was a bit naughty, because that can hurt. Gareth Davies got one in the back of the head, so it weren't all bad. Just madness, mate, madness.
Eddie, quick question. In light of the recent pay-per-view numbers, how many are you expecting for this one?
I don't know. The last one, 1.2 million global buyers. I think the last one did 400,000 in the UK, 400,000 in the US. But that was on at 3 p.m. US time, Eastern. This is a better time. This will be about 9 p.m. Eastern. Be earlier in the UK in the morning, 4 a.m. So probably a few less in the UK. Sky Sports pushing it hard. On box office, same price as last time, and I don't know. I mean, it's crazy. Like we sold like 6,000 or 7,000 tickets in the first couple of weeks. Like that doesn't happen in boxing in America, right? And they always buy late, so we'll have 18,000, 19,000 in the Staples Center. It's gonna be like the time Fight Week kicks in and all the Fight Week activities. The whole YouTube community will then be engaged. And by the way, it's my job as well to engage the fight community. Because at the moment, the fight community is saying, this is a joke, right? My credibility in the boxing, and I'm saying, I'm sorry, but you've got to explore this. Otherwise, you're an anorak and you're a dinosaur. So let me delve into this world and learn a little bit more about it. And it fascinates me, because I'm a numbers man, right? So I'm looking at the numbers, I'm looking at the streams, I'm looking at the pay-per-view, and I'm just thinking, and the digital interactions, social interactions, I'm thinking, we don't get this in boxing. Not that we don't get it, we don't even get it to a tenth of this in boxing. And I'm talking about for the biggest events out there.
Oh, just on that, Eddie, numbers, how does this compare in terms of viewership to AJ and Ruiz?
It won't do anywhere near the pay-per-view, UK pay-per-view, that AJ Ruiz will do. It will, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I think this does 400,000 or 500,000 sign-ups for DAZN. And I think AJ Ruiz will probably do the same kind of numbers for DAZN. You know, so.
What does that say about boxing, though?
It's just the new audience. Yeah, but it's the new audience. It's not just how you compare it to a boxing audience. It's how you compare it to any audience. Forget boxing. Look at any sport, like rugby. Cricket, golf, you think anything like that delivers numbers like this? Impossible. That's why like Sky look at it and they're like, we cannot believe it. Like we've got a YouTube channel, Matchroom YouTube, right? Matchroom Boxing YouTube. Subscribe, please. Thank you. We're small. We've got 70,000 members. We only just started. For the AJ Ruiz press conference, I think we got 9,000 or 10,000 watching live. Tonight, we got 30,000 watching live, right, on our YouTube channel. So, again, we're tiny. They got like 1 million or something like that. But that shows you three times as many people have watched this than the AJ Ruiz press conference. And they've gone to our YouTube channel. Hopefully, they stay, subscribe, and watch all our other content, start learning about the sport, investing in the sport. Oh, we watched the Regis Progress, Josh Taylor. Oh, you know what? We'll go to October 26th. That looks fun. This is how it starts. But even if you can get 1% of this audience, it's great for boxing. So embrace it.
What's your schedule for the rest of the week?
I'm going to... I just got back from New York last night. I'm going to Chicago on Wednesday for the Usyk fight. Then I'll come back on Sunday. And then we've got Newcastle next week. And then we've got Josh Taylor and Derek Chisora. Derek Chisora's opponent will be announced tomorrow, October 26th. And then we've got Manchester, Katie Taylor, Anthony Crawler. And then we've got KSI, November 9th. November 16th's a week off. November 23rd is Liverpool, Callum Smith against John Ryder. November 30th is our Monaco show for the Prince out there. December 7th is Saudi Arabia. December 13th is Danny Jacobs in New York. And December 21st, we might just throw in a show for good luck as well.
What about the Italian job?
Huh? Italian is this weekend, this Friday. Turchi against McCarthy, that's in Trento. And then we've got Milan on October 25th as well. We've got
two shows. One quick one on the price change. Why £9.99?
£9.99. Every pay-per-view on Sky is £19.95. I think they appreciate. This isn't, you know, a 6 p.m. till midnight world championship boxing. This is a 4 a.m., I say a specialist audience, but a different kind of audience. And they felt that was the right price. So
fans are paying for it. Can they expect Gibb?
Not on this show, but they can expect something else.
Brilliant. Thank you, Eddie.
Finally, it's a boxing question. Devin Haynes.